like gymnastics. Pan be tighter than leggings. My session rapper, he a fag. You not a gangster, you a actress. I'm a real gangster, check my stance. You a dick rider, where your man? Play with me and get dressed. Chopper be shooting fast.
It's your boy, Famous Animal TV. And who I got in this motherfucker with me today?
Hunter Rod,
Real talk. My motherfucking fans and shit been hit me up and shit, begging me to get out, you know what I'm saying, reach out to you and mine, get you on the show and shit. Mm-hmm. Hey, yeah, so mine, what been going on with you, man?
Mine, you know, pushing them rims and mine, getting that money out here. Mine, you know, just staying positive. Taking care of my kids, about it, you know.
Real talk. That 100 round shit for real.
I feel.
Yeah, like motherfuckers, man. Motherfucker mention your name, motherfucker be getting scared throughout the city and shit, man.
You know, they come from the haters that, man, you know, a nigga had problem, Will did something too, you know. I don't hurt me like everybody else. You know, niggas hating on me so bad, though, it spread like a disease. So a motherfucker never seen me think I'm this fucked up in the mind of that nigga, but when you get to meet me, you're like, damn, that nigga cool as a motherfucker. I don't know what they talking about. It's just like this, man. I got good heart, but you call me, I gotta get you, man.
Real talk.
If I love you, I love you. If I hate you, I hate you. But most time, I love people. Niggas done cross me and did sour shit to me, so that's how it be.
Real talk.
I ain't no bully. I don't pick on no nigga or nothing. You know how that shit be.
Real talk. That's what's up. So, like, man, I've been hearing about a lot of shit been happening, shit. Like, all folks been saying, like, you got shot and shit. You want to speak on some shit about that?
Yeah, I got shot 12 times, but you know.
Are you good?
I'm good. I can walk, talk, breathe, shit on my arm, no shit bad, none of that shit. I'm walking, doing whatever this nigga doing.
Real talk.
But, you know, I just look at life different now, man, you know. That God waking me up, telling me, man, I got you here for a reason. I could have took your life then, like. So it's just, man, I look at everything in a different aspect, like, this shit for real, you know what I'm saying? Real. I've been shot before, I've been shot in the head, but that was years ago, but being able to just getting shot and shit, like 12 times, this shit woke me up. This shit for real. I don't take nothing for granted no more. I take everything serious. I can't even let you threaten me, because I'm going to tell you, like, you're going to take my life for real. So I got to get you for you to get me type of shit, man.
Real talk. So, like, all right, by you being getting shot and shit, do you think this shit, like, you know what I'm saying, like, made you change your ways as far as, like, you know what I'm saying, the rap game? You still want to rap and shit?
Yeah, I'm still going to rap. I'm still going to talk pen and shit. I'm still going to motivate the street niggas, the strippers, the bitches, the boss bitches, the boss niggas. I'm going to motivate everybody to do this thing the right way. It's just, man, some shit I'm just going to cut out, and it's on my personal lifestyle. Some shit just, throw my hand and, like, fuck it. It ain't worth it. Some shit. Problems and some shit. It just, I'm gonna enjoy this shit, man. This shit, I just took shit for granted, man. Niggas take shit for granted, even like walking to the bathroom, wiping their ass, and even just getting up peeing, like, man. This shit for real, like, people take so much for granted about complaining and shit, man. We all blessed just to be woke type shit. That's how I look at life now, like, man, this shit. Man, I love the rap shit. I'm gonna continue to do this shit. I don't give a who with or against me or not. You like it, you like it. That's why I love the people who like it, who support me 100%.
Real talk.
Fuck a hater.
Man, real talk. That's what's up. So, like, you got that new music and shit finna hit the streets and shit?
Man, I just dropped some shit, man. Beginning of the month. Motor this. That shit banging, man.
Real talk.
That shit banging. Who you? Like, damn. I stayed now. See, I ain't take the rap shit serious at first. Man, back at 14, you know.
How long you started when you were 14?
Nah, 2014. I seen Boop doing it. I was like, shit, I might as well do it. I had did the little OG song with him, fucking around and jump. And I started taking it serious, but I realized you just can't go on there and say anything and think a motherfucker gonna love your shit. So I started writing. Man, shout out to Big D, man. Fat Wills and OG Rome. They made me sit down and write my own bar and give me a damn bar. So as I got along, every mixtape you gonna hear my development as a rapper, man, I'm getting better and better. So, man, if you been keeping with me as a fan, you be like, yeah, the boy have got better. It's just I didn't take it serious. From now, I take it serious.
Okay. Yeah. So, like, back then, when you dropped that joint with Boo Dirty, that OG joint, You know what I'm saying? Like, when you first did that jump and shit, like, motherfuckers, like, that one, like, when you did that jump, people started, like, mind, you need to, mind, go on rap, you need to go on rap, or you want just, or you just was in the streets, or you already had started developing rapping and all this shit.
I was in the streets swagging, man. The best streets had white folk every day type shit. I ain't give a fuck about no rap, but I just got this up, be a booze, just fucking around. I said, let me get on this jump. He did me get on this jump. And how it happened, he wrote my shit for me. I ain't gonna sugarcoat shit. I'm a real nigga. I don't lie. Really? Like, that day, it's just like, man, I was like, fuck that shit. But then I seen every time I go to the club, they play this mold of dick. Man, I said, damn. I started falling in love with the shit then.
Real talk. So did you think that shit right there was gonna, just being a part of street nigga and shit like that, you think that shit was gonna hold you? Like, is this shit holding you back by you being a real street nigga out here for real?
Like, beefing with nigga for real, that shit really hold against a nigga, because when you beef with a nigga, everybody in his family don't like you, and his friends don't like you, so they like, fuck that nigga, man.
Yeah.
You know, bitch, fuck, don't fuck with that nigga. So that's another 20, 30 enemies you created. That's another 60 plus. They friend, my shit. Like, niggas, you can tell who ain't never been in the streets. Hey. But they don't got no haters. Everybody love them. When you in the streets, man, you gonna have niggas who don't like you because either you ran off on them, you shot them, you robbed them, you beat them up, you finessed them, you did something, you fucked this bitch. You know how this shit go? I had real enemies. I did shit, man. You know, I ain't proud of shit, but I can't change what I done. You know what I'm saying?
Hey.
No regrets, man. I'm living shit. But my niggas who been in the street for real, they got real haters, and this shit hard to elevate you sometimes. Some niggas be real street niggas, but they just get money, and they ain't have no beef with nobody. But you know, I was one of them niggas, man, you know. I was loyal to my nigga. 98% of the beef was in mine. I was just riding type shit. But since I'm riding, my nine get put out there the most, because I'm the most known. Mm-hmm. It was motor. Half the time, one of my beef, I was just a loyal nigga to my nigga. That's how my mind got burnt up, being loyal.
Real talk. All right, so I really want to speak about this chain and shit, the chain accident and shit like that. Well, I ain't gonna say accident, the chain situation that took place. Like, you know what I'm saying? I had reached out to a couple people, and they were saying, like, man, when you went, like, you know what I'm saying, you went to go get the feature, you had about 20, 30 bands on you.
Man, I had about 30, 40 on me, number of hundreds, all blue boy, no white boy. Talking about.
Yeah.
Blue boy, like I was crippling like my nigga on Cat at night, was all blue, you hear me?
Real talk.
No, I'm talking about, I came up to the nigga on some mind peaceful shit. It was just me and my family, my nephews. I wasn't on no tough shit, but my brother them was in there. Cat, them, you know, a couple of my brother, Casino, no, they was there, but it wasn't no shit like, man, we finna ape this bitch. Ooh, they rustled, right? Nah, it was on some shit. I was like, man, I'm gonna ask the nigga for a feature, because I felt them in front of my mind. I feel dude moves. I been said on an interview with Wicked that I wanted to do something with him. I thought real street niggas get a vibe and link when they see each other. It's just a groove that we all don't get. But mine, that nigga was on some cocky drunk shit. Like, he was like, fuck me type shit.
Yeah, so all right, when he said that, do you think he said that because, like, he seen you like, damn, this is my big street nigga. I don't even want this nigga, you know what I'm saying?
To be honest, by it was plenty of niggas on the stage. RPJ Moneybag, no one's on the stage. But Moneybag don't know me. They were looking at me like, man, he with that bullshit. But the whole time, I don't know if a nigga told another nigga. I tell him, watch out for Mo, he on some bullshit. But I really wasn't on no bullshit. Man, I had just spent some money with Kevin Gates. No problem on the vlog.
Real
cashed him out and shot a video slime day type shit. For real, man, it was just, man, I don't know, man. It just nigga be hating on a nigga. And then if you and a nigga in competition with each other, they gonna do anything to make sure they eat before you eat. This shit I made work like a nanomile. Well, I'm gonna take you with me. Let me drop my jumper, then I'm gonna come back and get you, and we gonna take y'all together. Man, these niggas hurt like net to net. Nah, I'm gonna make sure that nigga don't blow. I'm gonna throw some salt on those four face so they won't fuck with them. That's why I believe having nigga really shit hate on me. So when I asked him, he was just like, got my face type shit. Like, he ain't wanna fuck with me like a nigga I already told him. Don't fuck with Big Dad over there, Tasha. I don't know. I really don't know, man, you know. But you know, the shit went down like it went down.
Real talk. So,
ain't no nigga disrespect me in my city.
Exactly. Real talk. So, like, do you ever feel like y'all can work something out and get back cool?
Man, you know, I ain't never threw the white flag in, but, man, you know, I'd rather get money than beef with a nigga any day. You
real
know?
Talk.
Didn't nobody die about the shit. The shit happened, man. Bygone can be bygone, you know. You know, so my nigga old and mature, man. I know he probably got kids he dealing for, man. You know, the pad, man. The shit happened. I can't change. You know, man.
Real talk, but you came with your money.
Yeah, I came with 30 or 40. Real talk. I'm going to tell who seen me with the shit. Cash. Shout out to Cash, man. He seen me with that shit for sure. Real I was talking about my for spending money, please. He was like, I don't holler. That's how it happened. We wasn't had no group meeting in the hood. Like, man, there you go. Forget that bitch. None of that. He ain't had some niggas with him. He talking about the son, he had two or three niggas. He had about five niggas with you.
Damn. That shit crazy.
Niggas bigger than me. 6'6", 330. And the bitch of car security guy, they walked to me like, hold on, bro. I looked at him in the eye. I said, nigga, you a bitch. Watch out. He bad though like a bitch.
Real talk. Cause they like, man, I ain't finna get in this shit. They don't like, yeah. Come on, man. Like before this shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Big motor, 100 round total. You know what I'm saying?
I got niggas in Carville, Tennessee. I ain't never came with no security guard. My own nigga walk up to me here. I go kicking with them niggas in Mississippi. They ain't gonna tell you what my motor will cock here. He'll shake a nigga hand. I'm like, what's up, what you wanna do? They'll do it future. You wanna do it, you will do it. Man, I ain't never been on no shit. Well, I don't think I'm better than you because I got a little bug. Man, you working hard as me. God bless me a certain way to deal you right now. But everybody had their turn. It's just certain niggas just cocky, man. You can't be cocky in no nigga city, man.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. So, like, do you think the industry rappers and shit, like, stop fucking with you because of that situation?
Not really, man. I ain't gonna lie. I talked to niggas like Kevin Gates and Walker. So when this shit happened, I talked to Bigger Rankin. And Bigger Rankin, man, I love you like a son, man. You know, you gotta thankful you at sometime, man. You know, that shit still scarred a nigga with the industry folk, but like, cause they like, how can we take a chance on him if he out here doing shit like that? You know, it did, but you know, I gotta make my own way and be a boss about this shit like Dawg did. He bossed up, didn't make no excuses and kept going. You know, I just gotta boss up out here and make my own way. If a nigga come to me and wanna fuck with me, that's cool. We can talk about it. But other than that, man, you know, I scarred myself, so I gotta deal with the consequences. It fucked me over a couple of DJs because people wanna make money. They don't wanna create enemies. So they rather make this money and be like, fuck that, I can't get no beef shit. You know, so people choose money over beef any day. So, you know, some folks went their way and told me how they felt about the situation. And I respect it like a man, then cry about the shit. So I dealt with the shit. And I'm still going at this day forward. Like, I'm still dropping mixtapes. I'm still dropping videos. I'm still going forward. Like, you know, if I make it, I make it. I don't.
Real talk, I feel. So, like, you know, it's a lot like, when every time they see Big Motor this or Big Motor that, 100 round total, it's a, like, man, it's like you be in tour with somebody, you beefing with somebody. Like, do it be like reasons behind this? Is like, is it street shit or the music industry type shit?
It's really street shit, man. It's shit. See, folks think I just be picking on folks just to get hot or find out for certain nigga. Nah, it be like every nigga beside Gleason, man. I had real history with like some niggas I grew up when I was 13, 14, come these nigga hood, gambling. We kicking it, we chilling day on the daily type shit, but then nigga get bigger, get a little money on smelling their ass. Nigga talking down on nigga like a real bitch, like nigga controlling the whole city, they the goon of the city. Niggas come through them like nigga know what's up, him and his nigga, like a nigga gotta bow down to a nigga. I'm like, hold on, bro, you doing all this out of town, but then when you see me, you shut my hand. One thing about me. If I can't say it to your face, I ain't gonna say it to your heart. I don't feel niggas who talk behind a nigga back and can't say it to a nigga face. If I don't fuck with you, it's just that. I don't gotta hate you or dislike you or talk down on you, it's just that. Niggas shake my hand, but talk behind my back, that's what they do to me. Like, niggas really don't fuck with me, but when they see me, they say I respect. Like, they don't want no problem at the same time they dislike a nigga. That's how I be. It be street shit. Come on, bro. I know when you were doing all this, now you this super tough ass nigga. That shit be crazy, you know. I know everybody.
Real talk. So, like, is Memphis still fucking with you, though?
Man, somewhat. That's what I think, but as long as I got confidence in myself, I get most of my love from out of town and shit. But I don't just think Memphis just fuck with me, man. You know, when that Gliz shit happened, my folks chose Gliz on me. And then a nigga, OG Boudreaux explained some shit to me and said, bro, how you expect these folks to ride with you? You just not getting into this shit, dude, got real lawyer fam. And some shit you just kind of outweigh and beat, and I had to understand it. But you know, my brothers was riding with me. I got a couple crip homies, Great Street, they were riding with me. My nigga know they five dudes, they were rocking with me. My nigga know they Trey. I got more crip friends than other niggas, you know. All my niggas know crip, I was around all Great Street, you know what I'm saying? You know, I'm finna buy a road. So I tell all them brothers out there, you know, but my, you know, the brothers were riding. It's just certain folks was like, who I thought was gonna ride, then stick their neck out for me when they had beef with certain motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? You know, when shit pop off and situations happen, you really gonna see who fuck with you. That's what I learned. I've been through a lot of shit and I learned it. Man, I don't take 30 niggas to act like you this and that. I keep little bro with me, that's it. We ain't 100 deep, we ain't 300-400 deep, but nigga no 100 around there, we gonna save life. We gonna earthquake this bitch. But niggas, man, niggas really choose they side when shit pop off. I love my city, man. When it was time to ride in March, I put my differences to the side, stood over my city. But you know, they still go fuck with the niggas who ain't come down there in March. But I can't be mad at nobody for their choice. I had to learn how to deal with people's opinions and take the shit and uplift myself and make myself a better person out this shit. I used to get mad when I see all them hating that coming because niggas don't say it to my face, but then I learned how to deal. I said, niggas like Drake them ain't getting hating on their comments and shit, so I learned how to deal with the shit and move forward and take the shit and make myself better out this shit.
Yeah, tell us something. Like, is you trying to get out the streets?
Yeah, I'm trying to get out the street, man. I got four kids, three girls, one boy. I'm trying to get these folks rich where they ain't have to do none of this shit I had to do or go through the same struggle. They gonna have struggles and learn different life lessons every day, but as far as I don't know what they gonna wear to school tomorrow, gotta go down the street and go get cuz shoes because his shoes fucked up. You know, I ain't trying to let them go through this shit. Material, this is shit will never be a problem. No, don't leave it. I don't want to go through none of this shit and be a daddy that fuck all the money and shit. My daddy wasn't there for period. My brother and my sister took care of me. Some shit I ain't have to do, but they did step up to the plate and do for them. That's why I love them to death for that shit. You know what I'm saying? Anytime they hit me for some of his zero understanding, I give it to them because I ain't have to step up. My dad a coward. That's why I'm trying to be a better dad than my kid.
That's what's up. Yeah, that street shit, that shit, it's a lot that come with that shit.
A lot come with it, man. The niggas who don't have to be in the street, ones who been on the street. Niggas stay off Germantown, Parkway, Miss Stanner, in a 5-bedroom, 12-bedroom house type shit. Be the ones thugging and want to shoot it out with a nigga. This nigga like me who trying to get this shit. And mine, never come back type shit, but give back to the city type shit. If you know, now you can't complain, but you gotta deal with the shit. These streets ain't what a nigga think it is, mine. I done lost so many homies and shit, my family and shit. That shit for real. Any of some motherfuckers on ain't beefing, just wanna live getting killed type shit. Babies and shit, this shit ain't what's up, man.
Yeah, talk, that shit crazy. Yeah. Alright, so like, you ain't never tried to reach out to like no artists, like no big artists and shit like Dolph, Yo Gotti, see if they were signing artists and shit like that?
Man, I reached out to Dolph. I seen him at the Mandel Center. We was talking. He just told me to keep going hard. You gonna make it. And there was no discussion on you gonna get signed by me. Now, we ain't even come by and say about DJ. He respect my grind. He loved the way I go hard by myself. I talked to Flocka. We just be on the street shit, really. I talked to Flocka, Gates, you know, Dolph. But he really wasn't on no other shit. Signed me type shit. They just fuck with me. They told me to keep going hard.
Real tough. You know, the rappers be want to be known and shit. They be want to know the street niggas, so when they come to the city, they know who to check in with it, you know?
Yeah, pay homage.
Real you know, tough.
Got a car, a green car. Okay, he okay with him, okay. I respect niggas who do that to me, though, because that's like showing respect for all the hard work you to put in the street and the sacrifices you change to get what they get. So they see you out here grinding, but they know it's certain things stopping you, and I respect you for that. It's about respect to me. Some rappers like being around real street niggas who got stories to tell. That motivate them to keep going. That's why they do this shit sometimes for us. Like, some niggas don't have to do that shit. I do that shit, just, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to be discrimination toward anybody. Like, okay, I don't want to fuck with them niggas because they GDs and I'm a violent lord. I want to fuck with everybody. At the end of the day, shit about money, man.
Real talk. So you went in to collab and work with anybody?
Anybody, man. Anybody. I ain't with that shit. Cause I'm fucking with a nigga. Every nigga got a story to tell. Cause you see it happening this way, don't mean it really happen that way. I get judged a lot, so why judge the next nigga type shit?
Real talk.
Now, all nigga gotta do is reach out. Cool as a fan, man.
Real talk. So is that, man, I ain't gonna hold you up and shit. Is there anything you want to let the world know, let the fans know, let anybody know who watching?
Stop hating so motherfucking much, man. You hear me? Don't go back with the next motherfucker tell you about a motherfucker. Get to learn a motherfucker and see if you like them yourself before you listen to them. That motherfucker, he just been hated all his life. If a motherfucker sit and talk about you all day till you're buying your bed, why you fucking with him? It's just too much hating going on, man. We, as a city, we gotta come together, man. Shout out to the folks who fuck with me, who love me. Shout out to them haters that keep me motivated. Shout out to my family. My kid, you know, other than that, if you a hater, fuck, hunt around shit for real, man.
Real talk. Let them motherfuckers know where to go get your new music and watch them videos.
My Spin Riller, YouTube, Live Mixtape, My Mixtape, all this shit. Go get that Moldy just dropped, man. That shit whining, man. Moldy dead, man. You know, videos on YouTube, I probably got close to 100 videos of my damn self, man. I got so many videos. You know, I'm just working, man. Supporting nigga, give nigga a chance, man.
Real talk.
Support the ones who want to give back to the city. But still, a nigga get rich, they don't acknowledge the motherfucking city they from. You feel me?
I feel that's what's up. Yeah, gonna let the world know what's going on, man.
Shout out to my boy Famous. I ain't TV, you know what's going on. Hunt around. Get with my nigga, real street nigga.
Real talk, for real.
Hunt around, motherfucker. Draco shit, bitch. Fuck you, man.
Hold around, hope.